Hi, this is Nicholson 1968. Welcome to my new project. To be a hero, you must know thy enemy. And what you just saw is a little excerpt from a deleted scene that came out after the new Batman versus Superman. It was put out by Warner Brothers. The name of that clip is called The Communion. I'll touch on that a little bit later in this video, but that was a deleted scene put out purposely, and they call it Communion. So I'll touch on that. But moving forward with this video, I'm going to show you some multiple things. And first of all, the reason I call it To Be a Hero, You Must Know the Enemy is a lot of people are focused on what the powers that are the elites that rule this world, or Satan, want you to be focused on, and not the real enemy. The real enemy and what the enemy is after. Typical of what's been rolled out this year, just look at the movies. Here we go. Let's just take the first one, obviously, is Batman versus Superman. These two guys are battling each other, and there's some spoilers in this video, so sorry, but Batman versus Superman. You're battling each other. Meanwhile, the real enemy, Lex Luthor, is planning a whole nother group of events, playing both sides, Batman and Superman. And eventually, the two sides come together and win out. But that's exactly what's going on today in today's world and what the elite do. But let's take the movies. Captain America, Civil War. There again, telling you, Civil War, you've got two sides that should be fighting together, but the enemy has them pitted against themselves. Meanwhile, they get to do what they need to do to pull off the crimes and do what they need to do. Let's take another one. The Huntsman, Winter's War. There's two evils fighting the two sisters. Civil War, propaganda, again, the Civil War. They're putting this stuff out there for pre-programming, and the masses don't even know, they don't even realize it. Also, another one is coming out this year called The Purge, which is the third one in the series of The Purge, election year. It's another movie of pitting Americans or a population against each other. Let's go to Allegiant, a movie as part of the Divergent series. It's pitting the impure and pure people in a population against each other. Meanwhile, the elites are pulling off the deception, the delusions to get what they want, and the people on the ground are too busy focused on each other, other than the people in high positions. You've got, obviously, The Hunger Games. Let's take the whole series of what's going on. You've got the elite. Got part of The Hunger Games is destroying each other, pitting one district against another, which they're not the enemies of each other. The one that's corrupt is the Capitol. So you've got all of these movies put into place that the underlying message is Civil War. You fight against each other. Meanwhile, the real enemy gets away with what their agenda is, whatever that may be in the movie or whatever. And it is reflective here in this world and what is going on this planet. I just wanted to kind of touch on that, of why this is going to be called To Be a Hero, You Must Know Thy Enemy. The other part is the reason a lot of people can't see who the true enemy is the elites. And when I say elites, I'm not saying they're better than us. When I say the elite, is elite meaning they rule right now. The powers that be, there's another, definition for the elite is those in power that are pushing the buttons. And that's what I mean. I'm not saying they're better than us when I say the elite. What is coming and why they set up things the way they do is they compartmentalize things. and they put things in sections. And when you do that, one person doesn't see the whole picture. This person over here doesn't see the whole picture of what's going on. But when you, like a flip chart, when you put them together, it tells a story. And that's kind of what I try to do here, is I try to take certain things, put them together so you see the one game, the bigger picture. Sometimes I get beat up a lot of, Nicholson, you need to focus on this. No, you need to focus in on this and this. And I try to do that, but I don't get caught up in just one certain thing as far as hoaxes, 9/11, just focus on that. I try to back up and show you everything that I can together to see a bigger picture. Now, what I'm going to share with you now is a perfect example of one part of the bigger picture. What you're looking at now is a website called Health Nut News. The author and writer and blogger behind this site is Miss Erin Elizabeth. A very talented, very down-to-earth person. I've been on a show with her on a panel, and what little that I've dealt with her, very sincere, very, very responsive, putting out a lot of good things. She also covers a lot of the deaths of the holistic doctors that have been coming out here recently over the last year. She has taken a lot of flack for that, a lot. And anyway, in my research of Morgellons, nanodust particles, if you're a follower of mine, you know the things that I've been researching for years and years and years, programmable matter, nanobots, things that are being, they're trying to force into humanity and to our bodies, force metals, man-made metals, not, there's good metals and there's bad metals, the man-made metals are bad for us. The metals in our teeth, mercury they used to put in our teeth, metals in the vaccines, metals in prescription drugs. I can go on and on and on. And that's why autism is happening. That's why cancers are happening. It's not some punishment from Almighty God. We're doing it to ourselves. So anyway, getting back to this young lady, she recently was attacked, a frequency attack on her phone, and I'm going to play the video clip, she put it out, of being attacked from wherever, frequency, and she had a phone. Now, I did a video right after the Super Bowl telling people about what is coming, the next part of the agenda of using cell phones, text triggers for control, those kind of things, that because things are about tones and frequencies more than people know. And I'll touch on that a little bit later, but the reason I wanted to mention her, I'm going to play this clip. This young lady, very talented or whatever, she's doing the right thing. She's seeing one piece of it. She even says that she's not really a conspiracy theorist, and that's okay. But when you combine the information that I have with her information, you start really understanding and put it together of the science community that doesn't want to look at the spiritual. You've got the spiritual community that doesn't want to look at the scientific community. You have to put it a little bit together there to figure out what's going on. Also, the powers that be do not want you knowing about nanoparticles and nanodust in food, sunscreen. Every time that I try to share a link to that, it is scrambled. An example is I did one on M&M's. I shared a link of all of the products, food products, that have those nanoparticles in them. And from a mobile phone, you cannot, unless you're really looking for it, you can't get there. You cannot get to the site. On a desktop and a laptop, you still can. But if you're looking at a phone or an iPad, it will not let you go. It'll go there immediately, and then it'll wipe away. It'll totally blank out the screen. And I'll leave the link to it, and you see if you can get there from a mobile phone. And anyway, So I want to share this clip with you. She was scared to death of what was going on. She was being attacked. So I'll play that, and then I'll be back, and we'll move forward. And this is just one little picture on the flip chart to put the big picture together.
I want you to see what the phone is doing. It's just going to call various people. Thank God I got this on video. See this, Billy? This is what's happening. I'm not dialing any of these numbers. I'm not touching the phone. Thank God. My phone, I've been gone 5 days. It doesn't do it. It only does it at my house. As you can see, someone else is controlling the phone, Billy. I'm not touching it. Here's my fingers on the sides, not touching anything. See? On the sides. Not touching the screen. There's nothing I'm touching on the side. Oh, look, it's typing to me. It told me earlier I had cancer, something about cancer. It's typing right now. It did not do this when I was out of town. Thank goodness I got it recorded. It's really getting scary. Sometimes they type me messages like, you have cancer. Wow. Okay, as you can see, the phone is acting on its own. I'm not doing anything. And there's nothing wrong with my phone. I was just out of town in LA at CalJam speaking with Dr. Mercola, and it did nothing. I want you to see this, and I'm going to probably put it on YouTube to show you that my phone is being controlled somehow by someone else. When we were gone and when I travel and when I'm not at home, I was just out for hours doing all my tests for my stem cells. It didn't ask. It didn't do anything like this. Only when I'm in my house is it doing this. Now, we have security watching the home because, you know, I've been writing about the dead doctors and they are concerned. But one of the things is if they were using devices on it, they said your phone would go haywire like this. I mean, if they were trying to use some, I don't know what kind of devices. In fact, I'm not a conspiracy theorist, so you see, I'm not touching the phone. Here, in fact, just so in case you think I'm touching like the side, I'm just going to hold it like this. So Billy, I want you to see this, and I want other folks to see this as well. And I'm not talking about Billy DeMoss. I will not be given a last name. But this is insane. And I didn't believe the medical doctors who told me that if my phone started acting up like this, and there's nothing wrong with the phone. I have been traveling. I've been, you know, various places. The phone has not had any problems at all. I was just out for hours today at the doctor's office filling out paperwork. No problems, only when I'm in my home, and especially outside in the yard. I was outside in the yard on the phone today, and it did this. Anyway, we have had experts come out to the house and explain if we watch for technical devices in the house start going haywire, if someone were trying to hit us with, you know, I don't know what they put on your house, devices that they have, and I didn't believe any of this. I honestly was a skeptic and thought these trained, some of them ex-federal agents, were insane to make such claims, but I'm starting to believe it. Not touching anything. Again, I can be traveling all the way to California, use my phone on a plane, it doesn't do anything, but as soon as I can home, it does this, and sometimes it actually types me messages. Earlier, I have one that says just said cancer over and over. You guys can think I'm insane, but I don't know how I could possibly, all my fingers are free here. Yeah, you can really get a good look. I don't know how I could possibly fake this. And thank goodness I had a camera nearby when this happened. I have had death threats made on my life since I began the series on the alternative doctors. I am with them. He has the number one health site for 19 years, holistic doctor in the country or world. Well, number one health site in the world. And this has got to stop. So I'm recording this, and we'll be sending it to the people who are helping keep an eye on what's going on. Again, I'm not paranoid. I still tell people not to live in fear, but I wanted to make a video to document this. You can see this, what's going on, and I'm going to put it on YouTube and send it to the proper channels right now. Would I send it to the authorities? I don't think they'd care, because we sent certified letters to the Federal Bureau of Investigation after, like, I don't know, the 20th, the 30th doctor, many of our friends who were found dead, alleged suicide or murdered, and the FBI didn't even bother to respond to the certified letters by the doctors demanding that an investigation be done. Is this coincidence? Sure, maybe all the deaths are coincidence, but there's no faking this. And I'm sure someone will say, oh, it's just a problem with your phone. again, I was in Atlanta. I was in Southern California. I was gone, away from my home today, you know, several miles away for hours. Great. Soon as I come home, the phone starts acting up again, especially outside in the yard.
So there you go, guys. I'm going to play a clip here for you from a movie. And I've said this before, is the powers that be show you certain things in the movies because they want you to believe it's science fiction. They want you to believe, nah, it's just a movie. And that's done on purpose. And it's put in our faces ahead of time and a lot of things like that. It's in the music videos, media, etc. So let's get real here. Is what is the real reason behind holistic doctors dying or being accidentally ruled deaths or whatever? See, this is what's going on, is when you start figuring out about the human body and what modern medicine, prescription drugs, vaccines, mercury in your teeth, you really start pushing some buttons of the New World Order, of that paradigm, is understanding what is being attempted over a long period of time for control of the human body. When you start realizing DNA is written code, it is a written code from the Creator. It is very highly complicated code, just like a computer code. So anybody out there that's touching on that information or getting to it, like Morgellons and things like that, you will probably be attacked frequency-wise, physically, verbally, whatever you want to say, because that is the hot button for the future. Hacking the temple of God, trying to, I mean, because see, that's what Satan, the enemy, is after. He wants to set himself up in the temple of God, declaring himself to be God. He basically wants to be one with you, or commune with you. And we'll get to that later from the first video that I played, communion of the body and the blood. But before that, I'm going to play this clip, and it speaks of nanoparticles, and you'll understand why they don't want any information out about nanoparticles and nanobots in a bad way. You watch for yourself.
One thing even they didn't know, though, I'm wired too. I replaced 98% of my own noodle with nanotissue years ago. But mine's different. It's built to send, to transmit, whereas every other nanocell that I put out there, including the ones in your head, Cable, designed to receive. I think it, and you do it.
See, nanocells are real small.
1,000 times smaller than these dust particulates. You inhale it, they go to work replicating, spreading like a virus, multiplying in exponentials. 6 months' time, I could have 100 million people converted, ditch diggers, porn stars, and presidents. Not one would be the wiser. 100 million people who buy what I want them to buy, vote how I want them to vote, do pretty much damn well anything I figure they ought to do.
New research in Britain has raised concerns about the potentially harmful effect of nanoparticles. The emerging technology is used in a variety of medicines and even sunscreen. The research found that the small particles could damage the DNA of cells.
They're tiny microscopic particles which can store and release drugs in specific areas of the body. As a result, nanoparticles are increasingly being used in medicine and surgery. But because the particles are so small, there's been growing concerns about potential toxicity.
There's an emerging sort of body of evidence that says that for some particles of certain scales and of certain materials, that there are potential health risks.
New British research has added to that concern. It found nanoparticles could damage cells without even entering them. Scientists found the particles change the function of cells and how they communicate with other cells.
What this study shows is that even with a barrier between the blood supply where the nanoparticles are and cells, that there can be damage to cells, and not just a bit of damage, but significant damage to the DNA.
One of the biggest areas of concerns has been the use of nanoparticles in sunscreen. A review this year by the Therapeutic Goods Administration found sunscreen was safe and that the particles didn't penetrate skin cells. If trends in science continue, there's no doubt nanoparticles will be used more and more.
We really need to do fairly sophisticated studies of the toxicity of nanoparticles before we use them extensively in humans.
The TGA says it will monitor scientific literature should any tangible safety concerns be identified. Sophie Scott, ABC News.
This next part speaks to prints, which is scary for me and confirmation at the same time. This was part of this video, Know Thy Enemy, which was already in it, and I had to re-edit it out, parts of it, because he passed away right in the middle of me making this video. But, and you'll see why, it speaks to exactly what I'm talking about. When you speak out about DNA and the human genome and chemtrails and things like that, you will be attacked. So I want you to listen to this part of the interview, and then I'm going to play a couple of his CD covers that tell you a story without telling you a story. He's telling you information in a roundabout way, because he has to be very careful. But you know, whether he was killed or not, you know, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, for me working on this video and what I'm sharing with you, and then this gentleman passes away, it's confirmation of exactly what I've been telling you. So you'll listen to the upcoming interview when he did a talk show, and then I'll play that, and then we'll continue. I'll come back and we'll go a little deeper even still.
It's obvious now that artists are supposed to own their master recordings. I mean, in the future, it'll be unconscionable to even think you can take somebody's creation and claim ownership of it. See, unfortunately, this discussion's going to start to barrel into a discussion about the human genome and the DNA and all the rest of it. When it gets there, then we're going to be in the deep water. Mm-hmm. See, so it's better to start the conversation now before we get into God talk, you know. When I saw the State of the Black Union, Dick Gregory really moved me and a lot of my friends. I show it to everybody that comes over the house, especially white folks, because they need to hear that, you know, so that they know more about all of us, because what he said affects all of us. He said something that really hit home about this phenomena of chemtrails. And, you know, when I was a kid, I used to see these trails in the sky all the time. And so, oh, that's cool. A jet just went over. And then you started to see a whole bunch of them. And next thing you know, everybody in your neighborhood was fighting and arguing, and you didn't know why. Okay, and you really didn't know why. I mean, everybody was fighting. So he started riffing about the chemtrails, and he started to say things that hit home so hard. And I would recommend that everybody try to get what he said online or wherever, and try to get a copy of it and just listen to it. Because I was so moved that I had to write the song. The other thing is, the first line of the song says, I was born on the same plantation in the United States of the red, white, and blue. And we live in a place now that feels just about like a plantation. We're all indentured servants, you know. When I found out there were 8 presidents before George Washington, I wanted to smack somebody. Mm-hmm. You know, I wanted to know why I was taught otherwise. Just tell me the whole story. I'll fill in the blanks. But don't tell me something that you think I'm supposed to know.
hope you're starting to see now a little clearer picture as I put another page in the book to flip for you. We're going to move on with what I started off in the beginning of this video of the communion, which was a deleted scene from Batman vs. Superman. So let's get right to the word communion, and we'll look it up. What does that mean? Communion, the bond uniting Christians as individuals and groups with each other and with Jesus Christ, is described as communion. So, from a Christianity standpoint, if you ask a Christian what is communion, it is in remembrance of what Jesus Christ did for us, died for our sins, so we could have salvation and becoming one with Him eventually. Okay, so let's take the secret societies, Satan, the adversary, whatever you want to say, to the other side of this. What do you think that is? And it's what I'm talking about, the communion of the blood and the body, trying to enter the temple of God, reconfigure it. It is an abomination that causes desolation in the temple of God, where God cannot dwell there anymore. It is very clear what Satan is after. What is going on is systematically over time throughout history, which this has been done before. There's nothing new under the sun. Solomon knew these secrets. Is slowly conditioning us to the mark of the beast, which is transhumanism. The getting humanity ready and trying to accept metals into our body, also to control them with certain tones and frequencies. As like I said, if you just come and look at one thing, you think the person is a conspiracy nut. But as you back up and you see all of the different pages, cloning, programmable matter, some people call it black goo. It is real. It can shape shift depending on, there's different levels of programmable matter. Look it up. You can go search it. It's there. There's no hiding it. It's a division, you know, it's synthetic biology that can self-replicate if programmed. That means it can reproduce if need be. Then you go into 3D printing, artificial intelligence, downloading your consciousness into another vessel or into a computer program. You're creating life another way, in essence. You can completely, you know, build a temple the wrong way. And that's what we're talking about here. That's why Jesus said that you tear this temple down, I'll rebuild it in 3 days. He was talking about his body. And so this clip, communion, is telling you something very deep with symbolism. Lex Luthor is in a bath of blood, you know, the mocking of the baptism of Christianity. Of course, the symbolism of the devil, Lucifer, the adversary, sitting there holding 3 cubes, Saturn worship, cube worship, call it whatever you want. You know what it represents to me is the cube is the copying of the life force that will replace the human heart, because that's where God dwells, is in the hearts of men. And that's the symbolism of taking it out of the human, making an iron man, replacing it with something else other than what's supposed to be there. So the 3 cubes, why 3? It's also mocking Father, Son, Holy Ghost. That's why they're show 3 cubes. Also, there's a part in this movie that I will show you. Hopefully, I won't get a copyright strike. That they're building a transhuman or a created person, and it's revolving around a cube, a vibrating cube. And a lot of people don't want to get on board with what's this cube stuff, and the Bible doesn't talk about it, and all this stuff. It's symbolism by the elite, the secret societies, and what it represents. And that's when you see so much cube stuff everywhere. Once you start seeing it, you open up your eyes, you'll start seeing it in movies, music, just in plain sight, religions, the cube. I'm going to take you a little deeper in the cube. I'm going to speak to it. I'm not just going to do video and music I've done this in the past, but I want to speak to it and I want to explain. What you're looking at is, in divine alchemy, this is a representation of the divine male, the triangle up. Then you have the triangle down, represents the divine feminine or female. Put them together, you get this star, which is not the Star of David. It's a representation of the human body, the human temple, together. Now, Satan is very clear, I've told you. He wants to sit in the temple of God, declaring himself to be God. So that means he wants to sit in both male and female. So here you go, the cube representing Satan, Saturn worship, cube worship, it's all the same, is in the middle of the male and the female. That's where he wants to set himself up, okay, in the cube. But take that cube out, insert it with the pentagram, which also fits within the male and the female body. And what did I tell you? He is the prince of the air. He is tones, frequencies. He is the prince of that. He wants to control with man and woman inside the temple. That right there, setting himself up. That's what that star on that flag in Israel represents. It has been hijacked. It ain't got anything to do with Jews. That is demonic, and that's what it represents, of the male and the female that Satan wants to conquer and be inside and set himself up, declaring himself to be God. You don't believe me? I'm going to share another clip with you upcoming from Disney. Donald Duck Disney, a little clip that tells you. If you can't figure it out, tones, frequencies, that's what's going on. The hijacking of frequencies and tones for control. Remember I told you from the last Super Bowl that Coldplay was performing their new album. You're looking at it. The new album is called Head Full of Dreams. So what we're talking about, downloading your consciousness, dream state, things like that. Title on there, Army of One. It's produced by Stargate and Digital Divide. Okay, so look at the cover. Looks pretty innocent, I guess, to the ones that are not awake, but most of my followers and subs already seen this. It's the Flower of Life, Birth of a New Race. Within it, the black is a cube shape. There's Saturn right there on the front of the album. Flower of Life, cube, rainbow colors, the days of Noah returning. What was happening? That's why it's very important that you learn what the Nephilim are about of Genesis 6:4. If you don't, you miss it completely. Totally miss everything. The tampering with God's creation, and he had to start over. And when it starts getting close to tampering with mankind again, guess what? Jesus Christ will return like in the days of Noah. You need to understand that statement. Oh, you remember we're talking about Superman versus Batman and Lex Corporation. Here you go. Look at Lex Corporation. Notice anything under Lex Corporation? There you go. Cube. X, Saturn, it's all the same. I mean, this is what we're talking about. Acts 4:11, the builders who are rejecting the true cornerstone. The builders who are rejecting the true cornerstone. Jesus Christ is the true cornerstone. They are building temples another way other than the way the Creator wants them built. Okay? So I'm going to share the Disney clip with you. You're going to see the symbol, the pentagram, and the tones. Notice that the builders are Masons. Masons are builders. Walt Disney, 33-degree Freemason. Builders who are rejecting the true cornerstone. I'll leave you with this clip, and then I'll be back. I've got some other stuff. We're going to go a little deeper. Thanks.
Let's go to ancient Greece, to the time of Pythagoras, the master egghead of them all.
Pythagoras?
The father of mathematics and music.
Mathematics and music?
Ah, you'll find mathematics in the darndest places. Watch. First, we'll need a string. Stretch it good and tight. Plunk it. Now divide in half. Plunk again. You see? It's the same tone, one octave higher. Now divide the next section. And the next. Pythagoras discovered the octave had a ratio of 2 to 1. With simple fractions, he got this. And from this harmony in numbers developed the musical scale of today. As their mathematical discoveries. Only members were allowed to attend. They had a secret emblem, the pentagram. It was our old friend Pythagoras who discovered that the pentagram was full of mathemagic. The two shorter lines combined exactly equal the third. And this line shows the magic proportions of the famous golden section. The second and third lines exactly equal the fourth. Once again, we have the golden section. But this is only the beginning. Hidden within the pentagram is a secret for creating a golden rectangle, which the Greeks admired for its beautiful proportions and magic qualities. The star contains the golden rectangle many times over. It's a most remarkable shape. It can mathematically reproduce itself indefinitely. All these rectangles have exactly the same proportions. This figure also contains a magic spiral that repeats the proportions of the golden section into infinity. Today, the golden rectangle is very much a part of our modern world. Modern painters have rediscovered the magic of these proportions. Indeed, this ideal proportion is to be found in life itself.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy! This is mathematics!
Donald.
Well, there you go. Walt Disney himself knew the secrets, and that's why it's called the Magic Kingdom. Magic Kingdom, a temple being built, temples being built from magic the wrong way. 33 degree masons. So that's the deeper meaning behind it. Kingdoms being built the wrong way. So I'm going to move on with another clip that I put out earlier in another video of mine, but it deserves to be put right next to this video clip of shapes and tones and frequencies. And it's a clip that I did, and you'll see it's of Katy Perry, of This Is How We Do. And this is what they're telling you. And I'm going to play this clip, and it goes into detail a little bit as far as the story of the Nephilim. So I'll play this and I'll be back. And also, stick with me. I've got some breakdown of Madonna's Rebel Tour, actual footage from her world tour entrance that speaks to what is really the purpose too of real life golems based on frequencies and tones. And it's right in front of our face on the stage, and you'll see it. So just stay tuned and I'll be right back. What you're looking at is a video, Katy Perry, This Is How We Do. Now, what you'll notice is with I'm not going to name any names. There's fellow YouTubers out there that claim to have discernment. They want to point out, oh, look, here's the checkerboard stuff. those kind of things. I know they've broken down Dark Horse, Katy Perry, Roar, E.T., Wide Awake. But if you'll notice, nobody has broken down this video. This is how we did. With the exception of a couple. But what they'll do is they'll just point out, okay, checkerboard right here. There's another section in here that a lady is wearing a 666 happy shirt. An all-seeing eye. But let me get to my point. Is the reason they cannot break this down is it's beyond the normal checkerboard floor, all-seeing eye, and pyramid. It's not a good video to break down for them, okay? But the reason why I'm showing you this, because you won't find it anywhere, maybe in a few places, is this is what the fallen are telling you of what's been going on. This is how we do. They are trying to rearrange the temple of God, shifting shapes around molecules, those kinds of things. Now, for your conspiracy theory people, you know, the reptilian shape-shifting thing, I'm not going down that road. I'm saying the temple of God is being tampered with. This is how we do. This is how we're putting together. We're rearranging the parts. This is why this video, which sounds a little, you know, goody feel, it's colorful, that thing. But there's something being told to. Well, I mean, watch. Here's the video right here. Look, they're putting something together constantly in this video. Look, put that together. Taco, you put pieces together. The whole thing has to do with shapes. This is an example of what I'm talking about. If you watch this video and what you're seeing on the screen, you see three women sitting in hands. You have fish floating around, so obviously they're in water. But here's what I'm saying is, if you don't know the language behind the scenes of the elite and the fallen of what they're using, this doesn't even make any sense. I guess the masses just go with it. But this is what I'm sharing with you is, I'm not a holy man. I'm not a righteous man. It's just what I'm fixing to share with you. Only something other than myself that is beyond me, the Holy Spirit, can share this with me. And here's what I'm saying. Look at this right here. These are the days of Noah during the flood, the fish. The three women are the daughters of men. These gentlemen who are dressed as Paul Rubens, Pee Wee Herman. Okay? For you who don't know Paul Rubens, he is Pee Wee Herman. He had his own show that he catered to the children, to look over the children and share knowledge and share with them. But Pee Wee Herman failed because he was caught doing something he wasn't supposed to be doing in the theater and some things like that. Now here it is. What's this? The fallen, dressed as Pee Wee Herman, are asking hand in marriage here. They're on their knees, marrying the daughters of men. Okay, days of Noah, dressed as Pee Wee Herman. Where did they fall? Mount Hermon, Pee Wee Herman. Also, the Nephilims were known as the giants. What is the opposite of giants? You're a Pee Wee. Occult, backward, symbolism. Right here, telling you something, days of Noah, the flood with a fish, asking, they found them beautiful. They took the daughter, all that they found fair as wives, on their knees, asking in marriage, dressed as Pee Wee Herman. Think about it. What has this got to do with anything of this is how we do Katy Perry, this video? Doesn't even make any sense, unless it's deciphered or decoded. The fallen took wives of their own, who they fared, the daughters of men, right there, Mount Hermon. They failed. Right there, symbolism, telling them. That's what I'm talking about. We've got to move beyond checkerboard floors, pyramids, and all-seeing eyes. Yes, we all see it now, but what is being told? What is the message? The days of Noah returning. They're showing you things. This is why this is, it seems like an innocent thing. Feel good kind of thing, this video. You know, this is how they do it. Entertainment. Distraction. I mean, this is why a lot of people are not going to show you the things I'm showing you. Because this is beyond me. What I'm being told and shown is beyond Nicholson 1968. I mean, there's a place in here too, I believe, with ice cream. Here you go, ice cream. Totally. It's ice cream. Look, ice cream starts off in one stage, and then it is frozen. Then it's shaped into a form. Ice cream. It's innocent. This is why they're doing this. This is why you see Nicki Minaj and them. You think it's a sexual thing when they're sucking on a popsicle and all of that. No, it's much deeper. It's moving the temple around, changing forms. It's the same thing, but just being reformulated to a certain degree. This is why the whole thing with the ice cream, the shifting of shapes and moving things around in the temple of God, the deeper meanings of these things. Well, I hope that put another page into your flip chart of the bigger picture one game that I've been talking about. I want to talk a little bit here of the video that I put out February of this year, February 11th, called Strength in Numbers. It was speaking to the next move to move forward with the agenda. It was a message, the Super Bowl 50 halftime show, and the commercials that ran within that time period is signaling to the elites to move forward with the next part of the agenda. 9 days after I made that video, on February 20th, a man in Michigan, his name was Jason Dalton, and I have a video to this already that I put out, was an Uber driver that killed 6 people, and he was motivated by this cell phone, he claims, the Uber app. Okay? I'll leave a link to the video that I made, referencing this event, that you probably didn't hear too much about it out there in the mainstream news, and you're not going to hear about it. When this stuff starts happening, you're not going to hear about the tech. You're just going to say he just went off and killed some people, whatever. But this is serious stuff that a lot of people know out there, not just me, but the Black Awakening, if you're not familiar with that, I'll share links to that. The Super Soldiers, the MK Ultra programmed people out in humanity among us now. And, you know, I'm going to share something very personal with you here that I've probably spoken to on the radio shows, but I've never made a video addressing it. But I am not inoculated. I do not have any vaccines. I have never taken flu shots. I eat as healthy as I can organically. I try to keep man-made metals away from my body, period. And I'm going to put this in the simplest terms. The Creator has a frequency all his own, and so does the Prince of the Air, Satan. And all that is being attempted is the rewiring of the temple of God, literally changing frequencies, jamming frequencies between you and the Creator. Some people are tuned in, some are not. Just like radio waves. The radio waves are happening around you right now, whether you're tuned in or not. So this is serious stuff about frequencies and tones and your DNA. Sound affects water. Your body is made up of 65 to 70% water. It affects it more than you're taught in schools, and the elites know this. They know quite well. And I'm going to share this with you. In Romans 10:9, it says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Now notice what is being told here, to confess it with your mouth out loud and do something within your heart. Believe in your heart, but you have to confess out loud. It's sound, frequency, tone. There's more to it, folks, of sealing your, to be sealed. That's all it is. To, you're sealing yourself by the things that you say. When people, you know, it's not silliness. It's more to it. So I'm just sharing that with you of the sounds, the tones, things that are coming down the pike, the mixing of the metals, it's basic stuff. I'm trying to not speak technical to it. I'm just trying to make it in layman's terms so everybody can understand what is really going on of knowing thy enemy and what I'm telling you. So this next trailer is from a movie coming out July 8th and pretty much speaks to itself. Remember what you've seen so far in this video that I've shared with you, and also what I shared on February 11th of the next part of the agenda. This movie, the trailer was not even released until I think the 1st of May, and maybe a little sooner than that. But it wasn't even released in February when I told you. So I'm going to play this next trailer from an upcoming movie, speaking of control by technology.
Passengers on flight 3598, your gate number has been...
Hi, Dad.
Hey, buddy.
Are you coming home?
Yeah. Soon.
Uh-huh. It's terrorists, right? It's gotta be terrorists.
Don't use your cell phone.
We're gonna survive. Just people are gonna die.
You okay?
They act for the good of the group as a whole. They may be the next stage in human evolution. What's happening now is more than temporary anarchy. It's the start of a war.
Are you coming home? Are you coming home? I just want you to come home.
Johnny's voice.
No, it's not.
You know that is not your son.
I just want you to come home.
Clay, no!
This next section is on Madonna's Rebel Heart World Tour intro. I'm telling you a very, very deep message. And of course, to the masses, it will seem just like another song and dance and over-the-top performance. Took me a little longer on this one. I had to consult with two different rabbis. It involves the Hebrew language, which you'll see coming up. It is one of the deepest decodes that I've had to date, really, because of the Hebrew language and how they use symbolism with it, and of course the occult mixed in with it, with the backwards and upside down, which you'll see. We're first going to start with Madonna's descension, coming down in a cube square cage. And the mocking, like I said, nothing is done by accident. Everything is meticulously put into place. This is speaking to Revelation 21:2 and also Revelation 21:16. So let me read you Revelation 21:2. It starts right here. And John saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. So here we have a vision from John seeing the holy city coming down. So let's take it to the next level, Revelation 21:16. What does the city look like? The city is laid out as a square. Square, cube. Its length is as great as its breadth. And he measured the city with a reed, 12,000 furlongs. Its length, breadth, and height are equal. So then you have the next verse, Revelation 21:3, and listen to what it's telling. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. So, do you understand what is going on here, what's being shown in an occult way? One thing is going on. God the Creator is got his purpose and plan, and Lucifer has got his plan of dwelling with mankind. Except, like I said, he wants to sit, notice, he wants to sit in the tabernacle of God, the temple of God, declaring himself to be God. In order to do that, he has to rearrange what is already in the temple and put things in it that God can't dwell and take him out of that temple so he can dwell in that temple. Remember, God does not dwell in a physical building. He does not dwell in a physical tabernacle. He does not dwell in anything made of human hands. So as you see Madonna descending from out of the sky, per se, symbolism, down to the people, the stage, and her guards, it's very important what she is showing you. Is, of course, she is dressed in red and black, satanic symbolism, being controlled as red and black. Red and black are not evil colors. They're red is red, black is black, but to use it in a certain way amongst the elite, that is their language of red and black, a symbolism of being controlled by Satan. You will notice on the guards, and this is very deep, folks, just hang with me. Like I said, I had to consult with a couple of rabbis, and we talked, Skyped. They don't wish to be named at this time, and I understand why. Anyway, on the top of these guards, the reason it was hard for them to make out, because it's not true Hebrew. Part of it's Hebrew, but it's a mixture of occult and Hebrewic language. The last part is Aeon, which is true Hebrew, meaning I. That's what it means, Aeon, I. The first part is reversed. It's a combination of Tav, Va, but it's upside down, which that's how the occult do, upside down. Tav meaning truth, so if it's upside down, it's the wrong truth. Tav is the last letter of the Hebrew word Emet, E-M-E-T, which means truth. Now, Vav is the sixth letter of the Hebrew alphabet, and also in representation of the Jewish tradition, the Vav is a representation of man. So what is being represented here on the top of these guards' helmets are the real truth being flipped, the real man being flipped, becoming a beast, the creation of something from the all-seeing eye. Exactly what I've been telling you, what God has been showing me to show with you. This is deep stuff. This is something that if you're not awake, you're not going to get it. If you're asleep, you know, I pray that you catch up of what is going on, the transhumanism movement, a new creation. So anyway, that's what's on the top of these guards. And I'm surprised that no one has researched it, or I haven't seen any videos exposing that's on their helmets right out there in the open. But I do want to go even a little deeper with you on this, because remember, Vav is also the sixth letter. The sixth letter, which is also the mark of the man. Man was created on the sixth day. Man works for 6 days, then he rests. So the beast is identified as the number of man, which is DNA. It changes you from a human to a beast. You're no longer of human origin, the way God has set creation in motion. So we're going to take it a little bit further here. That's very, very interesting, because I want to show you what Tav entails. Tav is the last letter of the Hebrew word Emet, which means truth, which I told you that, the reverse of truth, because it was upside down. Also, and here's the kicker. In Jewish mythology, it was the word Emet that was carved into the head of the golem, which ultimately gave it life. But when the letter Alf was erased from the golem's forehead, what was left was Met, means dead. So the golem died. So there you have a story of a Jewish monster being created. And let me get something clear here. Not all Jews are evil. the Jews that are lying, that are from the synagogue of Satan, which speaks of Revelation 2:9. So the Jews that are lying and that are from the synagogue of Satan are trying to create a golem, real-life golem monsters. A movie came out in 1920 called Golem, and instead of the marking being engraved in the forehead of the golem, it was engraved on the chest. And here you see a picture of what is on the chest of this golem. Is anything starting to look familiar here to you? Of Iron Man, the kingdom toward the end of iron and clay coming together, being that has to be broken up. This Iron Man with a star on its chest, look to the right side, FF. 66, 6 times 6, 36, 3 sixes, mark of the beast. The kingdoms of this world still belong to Satan for an age. Wake up, folks. There are no Christian-led kingdoms on the face of the earth. Thus the temptation of Christ by Satan. Bow down before me, I will give you the kingdoms of this world. They're his right now. It hasn't changed until he comes back. And to go and vote. It doesn't matter who you vote for. You can live in your little dream world. I'm telling you, I'm not being arrogant. I'm not being cocky. I'm showing you deep stuff here. The kingdoms of this world belong to Satan, period, until an age. And then it is broken up. This is what these elites are doing. So as you send off your young men fighting for democracy and freedom, and what got you fooled? Got you fooled. Babylon, everybody wants to talk about Babylon. Look, the attribute of Babylon, they sent off their mighty men to fight all over the world. What other country sends off their mighty men to fight all over the world? Do you think Iran sends its men all over the world? No, sure didn't. Sorry. I'm thankful, you know, for veterans, whatever, but we've been lied to. It's been hijacked. And like I said, you can wave your flag, wrap yourself up in an apple pie on 4th of July, but we're not there. We're not even there. Do your research. Do some studying. Quit going on what everybody's telling you. Dig deeper, folks. Put it together. Combine the pictures of the book together. Traditional Christians that come here with their indoctrination, that you think you know what you're talking about. Look, the reason I'm sitting here doing what I'm doing is because most of the churches ain't doing what they're supposed to be doing. Period. That's it. It's not being, again, I'm just telling you, I'm going to give you an example. I'm going to ask you a question. Everybody's sitting out there, I'm going to ask a question that says, Noah, story of Noah. How were the animals loaded onto the ark? Okay? Almost 99% of everybody that's going to answer this question, they're going to say two by two. Two by two. Because that's what's been drilled into your head. Oh, through books, everything. But let me read Genesis 7:2 to you. Of every clean beast thou shalt take thee by sevens, the male and his female. And the beasts that are not clean by two, the male and his female. Did you hear that, folks? Did you hear that? So when you come here talking about what you know, now I don't know everything, and I'm open to discussion. And if I don't know something, I'll say, you know what, I don't know something. I need to study more about it. Of every clean beast thou shalt take thee by sevens. Because Noah was not told how long he was going to be in the ark, so he took clean animals by sevens to eat. And then the unclean animal by two. That's why that's happened. And it goes much deeper than that. Because you also been lied to. That those out there who still believe that everything that you eat is clean. Because Jesus came and declared that everything is clean. But we're still dirty, but he cleaned everything else up, but he couldn't clean us up. Think about it. I just want you to think. That's what I do. Think. I make videos to make you think. See, because if you understood what is clean and still dirty, then you would understand what's going on with our body. Why the cancers? Why the autisms? It's right there. It's very important. You know, this is why I call this video Know Thy Enemy. And here's what you need to do. You need to quit listening to certain people who tell you who the enemy is and figure it out for yourself. Just like with me. You don't have to listen to me. You got the information. You do your own studying. I'm just sharing. So I'm trying to tell you who the enemy is, and I had to find it out the hard way myself, not just because some man up on the pulpit told me or some book that I read it in that was created by, you know, law professors and, you know, in the universities. You know, I got the good book, the Holy Bible, and went to work, did some prayer and did some study. You know, I don't want to turn this into a Bible meeting, but I'll just tell you, look, God gets a bad rap. Jesus Christ gets a bad rap. And I understand that for you out there. You don't want to hear it. I wouldn't want to hear it either if I had to listen to Pharisees and people that are teaching wrong information. See, that's the problem, is a lot of people are not coming to Christ because of hypocrites, idiots, judgmental people. And God has been overcomplicated by man. We're going to move on with some scientific for you. Researcher, great researcher, Harold, I hope I'm saying his name right, Kautz, K-A-U-T-Z, or Katz. He has done research on the black goo, Morgellons, you name it, transhumanism agenda. Out there, he's kind of put it together in a presentation. I'm just going to show you excerpts from it, but I can also share the link to his full seminar. Now, I may not agree with everything as far as his philosophy and theology on, you know, God and the Creator, but what I'm sharing with you, he's right on with the scientific findings, the things that he's going to discuss.
We want to talk about chemtrails. So the first question that comes up to my mind is, where does this word come from? And this is a question that is beyond theory, because you can find out where the word comes from. And it comes from soldiers of the U.S. Army, mostly U.S. Air Force, who brought this word into the English language, because they were sitting at the U.S. Air Force Academy, attending classes of the chemical faculty. And one of the classes is the chemtrail class. This is kind of, when you study at this university, the class where you learn how to make chemtrails. Yeah. This doesn't touch the question, do chemtrails exist up in the sky or not? The only thing we can answer by looking at this chemtrail class is we can see this is a military technology. We don't know if it is applied or not, but we can study the technology because it's taught at the university. So I started to get interested in internal papers of certain agencies. And there was one stupid mistake done by some network specialists in NASA. They published an internal paper, I think it's like 12, 15 years ago, that was classified, and it appeared for 2 days in the public domain of the main NASA website. And some people just, by incident, found it and copied the paper. And since then, actually, this is public domain. It's brought out every now and then. It's discussed by people every now and then. It's not like like a text that is giving a full description of what they are doing. Basically, it's just a PowerPoint that is displaying certain core terminologies. This is the paper in the original form. And the title is a little bit funny. It's Future Strategic Issues for Future Warfare. And they project this on the year 2025, as if they talk about future technologies. And then you have a very big, very small subtitle, The Future is Now. Now I'm a bit confused. Is it now or is it in 15, 20 years that this is going to be brought out? If you go into the entire thing, you find a number of irritating statements. This is kind of the second page, the little one on top. Bots, Borgs, and humans, welcome to the future. Bots is short term for nanobots, nanorobots. Borgs is a term coming from Star Wars, no, not Star Wars, the Star Trek filming. It's the species that is assimilating other species by turning them into half computer, half being. And humans, I guess they mean themselves, the one who are not affected by those games and rule the entire thing afterwards. And they just name a number of technologies that are going to be used in future wars. And they explicitly say the war of the future is not in between countries. They expect to have a world government. So the war happening on this planet is between the government and the normal people. And this completely different type of war will need completely different weapons. And then they list all those weapons. And there are certain things that are solved for them on nano level, on the level of nanoparticles, sensor swarms. If you have the nanoparticles in the air, it's a swarm. And it has smart dust. This is what something we will find later in the details we found in the environment. Nanotechs, things that are placed within the human body to give them opportunity to track you down every single second and read out what you think and what you feel. And something that is not explained in this paper, they call it co-opted insects, whatever this is. I just want to point out at this moment that this is in their paper, because we're going to find things that are going very much to remind us of these words. Other things in this paper that are worth mentioning, weapons that are apparently legal. Yeah, they are talking about weapons that are hidden somewhere in the civil domain. Everybody is dealing with them, everybody is using them, and one of them is the microwave. Microwave is used for mobile phones, it's used for smart meters, it's used for wireless LAN connections, and we're surrounded by microwaves, and they enter our body, and we think this is just a side effect of technical applications. But NASA classifies microwaves as a non-lethal weapon that is apparently legal. And they also name the effect of those weapons. It's behavioral performance decrements, seizures, gross alteration in brain function, 30 to 100% increase in brain flow, in blood flow in the brain, and also lethal effects that come over the time. So this is weapons brought out on mankind that NASA is openly talking about, just projecting it in the paper to the future. And we are falling for this. We think it's something clever to have a mobile on your head half of the day. What they also have, and this is something that refers to Kara's work, is explosive microdust that can be intelligently moved through the air to certain points, to certain areas. You can up-concentrate it and form an explosive lens. And it can also go intentionally into human beings to kill them from inside. They say that it's clever enough, the system, to go into underground facilities with the dust, with the explosive dust, to access people who are hiding down there. And then there's a new field of research. They realized that the base pairs can be mounted into a chain in a way that functions like a computer, like a logical element. And this is if you visualize this, it's like the old method with telephones when you were dialing with sound. Every base pair has a resonance frequency. It's somewhere in the terahertz range, and if you hit the right frequency, it is opening, like a light conducting unit. And if you have a chain of these base pairs that react on different frequencies, you need a sequence of sounds to open all the fragments to make the entire thing conductive. So it goes like do-do-do-do-do-do, and then the next part of the genetic thing is activated to either produce light or to produce poison. And this is something beautiful out of their view of the world, because if you bring this RNA or DNA into the human body, you can kind of take a radio signal and activate it from outside to produce any substance you want or to produce any light you want. Light is emotion, light is thought, light is everything. Everything we sense as experience of ourselves. And a substance can do everything with us. It can poison us slowly, it can kill us immediately. And this is controllable by radio frequencies without risking that it is triggered without anyone to want it being triggered. And the guy said, actually, we know that this is dangerous to bring this out, so we, that was in the papers, so we introduced the deactivation code, like a line of sounds that is completely taking the system out, and so that it cannot be abused by other entities. This is what he said. And he said this is airborne since 2003 in Europe. And he said that the second war, the last war in Iraq, was only done to test the system. It was the only real reason for the war. This is what he wanted to tell us, or from my point of view, the important stuff. Then he said some things aside that I counted to be very, very important. I don't think he did. He said they spent half a year and $10 billion to optimize the cluster topology. And this is something that I guess says nothing to anyone here, but if you're into the topic, if it's like having a virus and you want to bring the virus into a human being to have him infected with this, cluster topology is of no interest. You need to think about cluster topologies if you want to have this RNA or DNA clusters carry intelligence, carry soul, carry an artificial life form. Then it makes sense. And if you picture this, we are infected with this RNA. And the RNA is forming a cluster of 1 millimeter distances around us. And a cluster like this is able to carry a computer program or an artificial, non-physical structure or being. This structure can hoover through the field, but it also can hoover into us. And this structure knows how to access the light production, and it knows how to access the production of poisons. If you look exactly at the medical research concerning mad cow disease, you find that there are three reasons to get this disease: a lack of copper within the body, too much mercury in the body, and these nanocrystals. And what happens then is that the mercury is stripping the nervous system, destroying the protective layers on the nerves. The copper, the lack of copper in the body, makes the single nerves dissolve into chain parts. It's a protein, a prion, and a copper, protein, prion, copper. If you suck out the copper, it falls into pieces. This is how they can diagnose BSE, TSE. By measuring these protein prion particles. And then something very interesting happens. These protein prion things try to rebuild the nervous system. It is a self-healing process of the body. But if you don't have copper, you cannot rebuild the nervous system. So the body is taking the next heavy metals it can access, and this is barium and strontium. So it starts building a nervous system that is based on protein, prion, barium, and this is kind of an antenna for electromagnetic fields. So we are rebuilding a nervous system that is sensitive on electromagnetic fields. And not only that the nerve itself becomes sensitive, also, the barium strontium titanate nanocrystals, they display barium and strontium on their surface from the crystalline structure, and the new built nerves kind of grow onto the crystal. So what you get is a new connecting point for the nervous system that is piezoelectric. And whenever this is receiving a signal, it's firing electrons. So you have a direct access to the nervous system of the human being. This is one nanobot that you can find in the literature. Nobody knows that it is 100% identical with TSE, with the mad cow disease, and with the Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. So this to this particle. It's you can see, if you look into the military domain, they use it for radar range enhancement, for turning the sky into optical lenses and optical mirror setup. You call it horizontal drift plasma antennas and columnar focal lenses, so that they can play with electromagnetic signals and radar signals by turning the entire air, the particulate plasma they bring out, into a controllable technical unit to direct and redirect all sorts of signals. This is part of the rocket field in the military domain. If you want to destroy a Russian rocket approaching London, you just calculate the path, and then you activate the plasma and heat up the plasma to 10,000 degrees. And then the rocket is melting in the air and exploding. This is the rocket shield we have. And this needs to be spread out over the entire territory of Europe to have it everywhere. So this is the military domain, but as you see, some of the aspects of this particulate plasma are connected to diseases and to attempts to get access to the nervous system of humans. So this is the second agenda that appears on the monitor, which is not about military technology, but already about controlling the civil population of countries by accessing their nervous system to introduce signals. Okay. The next thing that you can find in environmental monitoring are Morgellons. If you look at the things the vaccination is containing, starting with mercury, this is pure poison. Starting with the shellats that pull out copper from your body, you start realizing that there's a plan behind it. This is, we know all this about the TSE scandal because of one guy called Purdy. He was a farmer in Great Britain that had a biological run farm. And he refused mandatory vaccination for his animals. And none of his cattle had TSE, not a single one, just because he refused the vaccination. And this was the moment when he woke up. And 10 months later, he died of brain cancer. Just to refer to the list of microwave weapons and their application. In the NASA presentation, we have the nanotags that are apparently there to track down people, to find out where they are and what they think. The first public nice, detailed public description was in the book of Cara St. Louis Farrelly, The Sun Thief, where she says that there are hollow fibers sprayed, self-replicating hollow fibers that are there to kind of read out the light fingerprint of your DNA, transform it into an electromagnetic radio signal that is detectable via satellite and ground stations. This is what she found out by analyzing information dealt with the chemtrail communities in the United States. She never mentioned the name Morgellons in her book, but if you look at these Morgellons, who had heard about the Morgellons disease? Half of you, okay. Let's just have a look at them. Nice creatures. This is a German tomato that got some German rain on top of itself.
Is that real time?
This is real time, yes. Now watch the Morgellon, what he does. He loves us. He's getting excited and he's trying to get close. I don't know exactly what they react on, maybe on infrared radiation. So these are basically, it's mycelium of a certain type of fungus. And this fungus is, first, if you want to look at it, it's airborne. It's not a single fiber here and there. It is glowing under UV light. So if you take a UV lamp at night, you can see those fibers airborne. And there are billions of them. Not every night, but every now and then. You can see them fly around. And these fibers, these fungus, is infecting the human body. And with 95% or 99% of the people, nothing special happens. They're just embedded somewhere, and your biology is keeping the fungus population low in your body. They just function as a plasmonic antenna to send out a signal, but you don't get sick from it. You don't get ill. No visible symptoms. So we would guess 100% of the population in Europe is infected. It's not a big deal, it's not dangerous, as long as the body can handle these things. Some of the people cannot handle it. And then the mycelium is starting to grow within the body and starting to multiply. And at a certain point, they are extracted via the skin. And you can see that they have this ability to collect colors. You have blue Morgellons and you have red Morgellons. And nobody knows where these colors come from because they are of technical origin. It's not a natural substance. So you can see them when the skin is opening. You can see them under the microscope if you make a blood analysis. You can see that the blood is infected. And you can let them grow artificially in a Petri dish. And if you look at them, you see they're a little bit more complex than a simple fungus. They have kind of organs inside. They have little red stem cells of an unknown species that are self-replicating as well. And apparently they produce other structure. This looks like a sporing body. It's like the unit where the mycelium at a certain point is forming a mushroom, a fruiting body. And then from the fruiting body you would expect the spores for the next generation, if this is a mushroom, if this is a fungus. So this seems to be the containment for the spores, because if you put this into the Petri dish, you can see the next generation growing. And other things you find, now it's getting fringe, it's really getting fringe, is fragments of insect skin being extracted from a Morgellon victim. So something makes these, something from this disease is making insect parts or insects grow within the human body. Did I say co-opted insects when we had this NASA paper? We're getting there. To understand what this is all about, at first sight this is a disease that should be cured. We worked on finding a remedy to cure Morgellons disease. It's easy. You don't even need to fight the Morgellons. You just need to reestablish a healthy environment within the human body. Take out the acids, take out the heavy metals, cure the function of the liver, that is irritated by mercury and that is irritated by a disturbed candida environment. This is due to antibiotics. So this goes, in the medical domain, this goes back to vaccinations, to antibiotics, which is completely disturbing our system. And at the end of the line, the Morgellon is kind of trying to save us from all the poisons that are within us. Save us from the acids, save us from the heavy metals by containing them. This is why the body allows them to grow. So this is actually not a disease that is infecting us with bad intentions. Everybody is infected, but the one who has too much heavy metals in the system will show symptoms because he will love these fungus to replicate and suck in all these heavy metals. And if you look at this, you can find all the things connected to the Morgellons disease. You find like large area self-assembled plasmonic photonic crystals. If you go into this publication, you find these hexagonal forms. And if you look for the function, actually this is a thing that is collecting a radio signal and turning the radio frequency into DNA-readable light impulses within the body. So this is the reading unit. If you look down there, you have photonic crystal fibers. If you look what they do, it's normally they talk about carbon nanotubes filled with these colors, with these quantum dot chemistry. And the function is to collect light processed by the DNA and turn it into a readable signal. Exactly what Cara St. Louis described in her novel. And if you put the two together, this goes beyond the novel. You get a read-write unit. I can take one person, make him angry, read out his anger, digitize it, put it on an antenna, and address 100 people that are not angry. And if they have this biology within their system, they will feel exactly the same experience of anger that I read out from the single person.
When I was a kid, I used to see these trails in the sky all the time and say, oh, that's cool. A jet just went over. And then you started to see a whole bunch of them. And next thing you know, everybody in your neighborhood was fighting and arguing and you didn't know why. Okay? And you really didn't know why. I mean, everybody was fighting.
So what do I need? Do I need an Arabic Spring? Easy. Just introduce some anger to the system. Yeah, so this is basically the possibilities that lie within a read-write unit, like a tape recorder. Record the human experience, the overall human experience of a human, and you can tell by the colors what this includes. Blue is the light that we process for thinking, and red is the light we process for sexuality. So they control our egos, they control our minds, and they control our sexuality. Blue is the light that we process for thinking, and red is the light we process for sexuality. So they control our egos, they control our minds, and they control our sexuality. Blue is the light that we process for thinking, and red is the light we process for sexuality. So they control our egos, they control our minds, and they control our sexuality. Blue is the light that we process for thinking, and red is the light we process for sexuality. So they control our egos, they control our minds, and they control our sexuality. And if anyone has doubts if this is really online, the system, there's another Morgellon victim in the United States. She just calls herself Jan. And she had one of these hexagonal photonic plasmonic crystals coming out of her skin here. And she put it under the microscope and caught it while working. So this was the first view on the particulate. It's not perfectly shaped in the hexagonal form, but you can see at least the angles at certain points. And this thing is controlled by microwave. Now there are a few more aspects of this Morgellon disease that are a little bit strange. Morgellon victims have this sensation of insects crawling through their body. It's sometimes the disease is called delusional parasitosis. And the doctors say this is pure madness, and normally what they give is psychopharmaca. I guess to get the people quiet. And what I observe out of this point of view when I look at Morgellon disease, it looks like a higher dimensional being abusing humans to reproduce his own species. And before these pseudomorphic fruiting bodies leave the body, they extract enough biophotons from the forehead to ascend to a parallel dimension. And from then on, they're invisible. But they're still within the body. And this now is pure science. This is what we found in the lab. This is what can be explained with higher dimensional theories. But it also refers to mythology. If you have an invisible creature crawling through your body, trying to access your energetic system, this is very close to what one might call a demon or an archon. And if you look at the descriptions of these archons from 2,500 years ago, the description of the biology is identical with what these Morgellon victim was painting. They're described as spiders with human faces, and there are exactly two different species that are close relatives but different. And it is described that they live as light parasites, and this is basically what the entire black magic tradition is about. Being a black magician means to communicate with those archons and offering them access to your physical light system, feeding them with biophotons, feeding them with life force, and in exchange they offer power. Power over other human beings. This is what black magic rituals are always about. So you need to multiply the symptoms to give the system a kick to start realizing where the enemy is. And then transformation can happen. So this is what we are heading to. And if you know this, you can be completely free of fear because you know what is coming to us. And if you realize that actually also all this bullshit I've been lecturing about today is not dangerous, if you bring yourself into the state of heart, because they're addressing blue and red. And if you're green, if everything is controlled by your heart, if you identify yourself with your heart, not with your head, not with your ego, then every attempt to manipulate you is realized as an attempt to manipulate you, because you know who you are. So there's no need to be afraid of this stuff if you take the necessary steps in your own development.
Now, for this next section, I am not teaching Gnosticism or anything like that. I am going to share what they believe. When I say they, I mean the elite, the enemy, the adversary, and what they believe. They believe in magic. They don't believe in miracles. They believe in magic and manipulating God's laws, mathematics, geometry, sound, frequency. Okay, so for you out there that want to twist what I'm going to say next, I'm just setting you up that I'm sharing information that is no coincidence. It's too big, it's too major to be a coincidence, but I'm going to share with you. What you're looking at on the back of the dollar bill is a pyramid. Below the all-seeing eye is 72 bricks. The all-seeing eye is the 73rd brick. It is hovering above the pyramid, waiting to be completed. Okay? So, I'm going to tell you, I've told you in earlier videos, the elites have a language all their own. And when you ask the world what 66 out of 6 means, they'll give you an answer, 72. 66 out of 6. 72. Okay? You ask the elites, 66 out of 6, 666. So to the elite, 72 is the equivalent to 666, the mark of the beast. So what you're looking at and what is attempted and is what is going to be attempted and trying to be attempted to do is the all-seeing eye above the 666, the people who take the mark of the beast, are 72. When it's completed, the all-seeing eye, that temple, will be completed and be controlled. It will be completed. The people who take the mark of the beast will be controlled by the all-seeing eye. I hope you see that, okay? Now, you may not believe that, but I'm going to take it a step further. the Lesser Keys of Solon, the 72 Goshe demons. Solomon knew secrets. He knew how to invoke demons and angels for his bidding. 72. Okay, 666. Look what I'm sharing. The controlling of those, this magic, magical symbols, magical things put in place, structures on the face of this earth put in certain places, ley lines. A lot of people out there, YouTubers, are doing good work on things are falling along the 33rd parallel. It's no accident. They're putting things in place on the planet because I told you about frequencies and tones put in strategic places, okay? So let me move on. That's on the back of your dollar bill. So let's go to Washington, the apotheosis of Washington, above the ceiling in the rotunda of the United States Capitol building, okay? You're going to see Washington. He is among the gods, okay? He is surrounded by, we're going to go from the outer. He is surrounded by 72 pentagrams. Count them for yourself. 72 pentagrams. What did I tell you about the pentagram that put into that star that it's talking about? Okay, becoming a god. Okay, apotheoso simply means ascending and becoming a god. Okay. So you become a god over what? Okay, that goes to the next outer realm of god of war, freedom, which is war, also known as Columbia. Then you have science, Minerva, the Roman goddess of crafts and wisdom. Then you have marine. The scene shows Neptune, a Roman sea god over the sea. You have Mercury, commerce, the Roman god of commerce. Mechanics, which is Vulcan, the Roman god of fire and forge. Agriculture, Ceres, the Roman goddess of agriculture. So what you have here is a statement. George Washington, the first free Masonic president, with their rule over all these different sections on the face of the earth with Satan. These kingdoms ruling all these different, so they're telling you right there in imagery, their symbolism. They are the builders who are rejecting the true cornerstone. They do not want to answer to Jesus Christ and the Creator when He returns. This is why they're trying to ascend, trying to ascend another way other than the Creator's way. It's obvious. So, you know, things are put in place. I'm going to show you this bringing energy. Battery Park in New York City. The buildings at the top of them, look at the top of these buildings. They're all different sections. Now, the architect of these three buildings are the same, okay? So, to bring energy of alchemy, which you have the pyramid triangle, the circle or the dome, and then the square. Okay? All those are attributes of the alchemy symbol. But now look at the buildings. The top three put together form that symbol. This is what they do and what they believe. They put it together. That's why you see almost every city in the United States, the highest buildings are usually the banks, bank buildings, and they'll have a pyramid shape on the top, or a dome or whatever, or a combination of all three, because they design it that way. They're the builders. And when I mean builders, with the physical and the spiritual. Physical, they put things in place to bring energy that way. That's obvious, you can see. But then the other things they're doing behind closed doors for the higher up degrees, they're trying to build temples another way and to control those temples with this technology, but also trying to ascend themselves. That's where the transhumanism comes in the future, is trying to become God's immortal with technology and man's intellect, while also using the technology to enslave the rest of the race that's left on the face of this earth. So these are the deeper secrets behind the tones, the frequencies, geometry, math, symbolism put into place, and magic. You know, this is known, as the great work, the craft. Just go back to what I was telling you about the energy. Don't believe me or whatever. It's called Battery Park. What's a battery do? A battery gives it energy, power something. See, it's no accident. It's very methodical over a long period of time. This is something that didn't just start 10, 20 years ago. This is eons of running its course. And they're running a marathon. We're running, just a short sprint. And that's why it's hard for people to believe in conspiracies, that's the whole thing, is people nowadays only know 30, 40, years of lifespan being on the earth. And this is something that's why I said I have to back up and put many pictures together to make the complete flip chart in the book, or the bigger picture, the one game. It's something much bigger than one generation. That's why I call it the one game, and everything else is smoke and mirrors. And if you get caught up in just what is happening in your generation and not thinking, I think there's the old cliche or the saying that those that repeat from the past are doomed for the future, per se. It's good to learn about the past, what we know, to move forward in the future and be prepared and be aware and looking and watching for the true enemy, not where the true enemy has got you focused on Islam, and then they've got Islam focus on Christianity. So I hope you see that, of why 9/11 was brought. You have to look at my about section on my website of my video. Is that's one of the reasons 9/11 was brought about, is the fighting between Christianity and Islam world. Because the real enemy is sitting back in the corner watching us beat each other up big time. Black against white, Christian against Muslim, women against men, it doesn't matter. On and on and on. You can go down the list of the distractions and the diversions. It seems real to you at the time, but if you just step back for a moment, look in the corner of who's sitting over there manipulating us to fight each other, that is the real enemy that is going on, and you must see that. Don't get hung up on all these little diversions of what's going on. We're all brothers here on the face of this earth. We're all brothers here. You may not agree with that, and I agree. There's real beheadings going on. There's real stuff going on. I'm not denying it. I'm just saying, but if everybody knew who the real enemy was, we wouldn't be fighting each other.
In the next 100 days, I will meet with a leader who rules over millions with an iron fist, who owns the airwaves and uses his power to crush all would challenge his authority at the ballot box. It's good to see you, Mayor Bloomberg. In the next 100 days, I will strongly consider losing my cool. Finally, I believe that my next 100 days will be so successful, I will be able to complete them in 72 days. And on the 73rd day, I will rest. That my next 100 days will be so successful, I will be able to complete them in 72 days. And on the 73rd day, I will rest.
Ha, ha, ha.